Well, right now, millions of Aussies are finding life harder than ever, and for many, it's the sky-high cost of housing causing them the most pain. Now, there are calls to finally fix the problem once and for all.
After being forced to spend around 80% of her income on rent, Vaye Arundel can no longer afford a roof over her head.
There were so many rent increases and I just couldn't keep up with them. At the moment, I'm living with my brother. Pretty much out of luck, he had a spare room.
Vaye's on the disability support pension, priced out of the market in inner city Melbourne where she's been living. She now doesn't know what her next move will be.
I'm not actually sure how long I can stay here. And honestly, at this point, I'm looking at squatting next because I don't see myself re-entering the rental market.
Vaye is one of more than 5 million Aussies living on some kind of income support, and a new report out today shows almost all of them are experiencing housing stress.
We're seeing that these people are really doing it tough because, as we all know, it's hard enough for people on average and middle incomes to keep up with rent increases. It's even tougher for people on the lowest.
For those people, almost anywhere in Australia is now unaffordable, but our capital cities are by far the worst. A single person on the minimum wage could now have to pay 78% of their weekly income to cover the average unit. Singles on JobSeeker have to find an extra $122 a week. That's before they even get to basic costs like food, utility bills and transport.
People are having to do things like move back in with their parents, crash on the couch of friends, sleep in their cars. You're skipping meals, you're skipping appointments, you're not filling up your car.
On Friday, millions of Aussies received a 10% boost in their rent assistance. But for many, that's just $23 a fortnight. And with the rent of an average unit now sitting at $547 a week, a 47% increase in less than 5 years, neither Centrelink nor the minimum wage is keeping pace.
We really need to start seeing these Centrelink payments especially get raised to the poverty line because these tiny increases are just getting completely swallowed up by rent.
For Vaye, her future feels hopeless.
Honestly, I'm too burnt out to care anymore, but something has to change or else I can't see much else in my future beyond potentially squatting or couch surfing.
Rental advocate Joel Dignam is here to talk to us about what is going on. Joel, just how bad are things for Aussies on the minimum wage right now?
Yeah, things are really tough. If you're on minimum wage, you're earning about $24 an hour. And so you can imagine it doesn't go very far when you're paying rents that have been rocketing up on top of other expenses that so many people are struggling with as well, groceries, fuel costs, energy, it leaves very little left over.
Now, we've been talking about the rental crisis for what feels like forever. Who's at fault here?
Yeah, look, this crisis has unfortunately been growing over decades from across multiple different governments. I think a good question for us to ask is who can do something about solving it now? And really, there is a big role for the Commonwealth to play here. They are the ones who have the levers at their disposal to make a big dent in this problem.
So what does that mean? What can they do? They've got the levers at their disposal. What exactly do they need to do?
Yeah, so one thing they can do, and they have begun doing this, but would love to see more ambition, is investing in public and community housing. That housing makes such a big difference to people who struggle in the private rental market. It's a way to get more supply online and give people an affordable, secure home, which is such an important foundation for your life.
So there's a massive fight in Parliament about this at the moment. The Greens are advocating for rent caps and rent freezes. A lot of economists say that that will just create a shortage and it'll be catastrophic in the long run. Do you have a view on that?
We would love to see governments do more to limit rents. I think some of these arguments against rent caps are really from a different time and a different sort of policy design. In the ACT, where, for example, there are limits on rent increases, we have one of the higher vacancy rates in the country and some of the improving rental affordability. So I think there are ways to get this right that can get both of those things, make sure people have affordable rentals as well as bring new supply online.
If nothing changes elsewhere, what is the worst case scenario here? We've had this conversation so many times, but is there a tipping point? What happens?
We are seeing the growth of an underclass of people in Australia who are going out to work every day and they're barely able to make ends meet and they cannot see how that gets any better for them. And we're hearing from those people more and more often. At the same time, the people who own property are owning more property and growing their wealth. We're seeing a real gap growing between these two people, and I think that's not where we want to go as Australia, and it is something we need to turn around.
All right, Joel, thank you very much for your time tonight.
A pleasure. Thank you.